Islam, and our paper is Education Data Mining and Student Performance Prediction. So before going into this, what is data mining? Data mining is a process of discovering the patterns in the large data. The uses of data mining is that marketing segmentation, fraud detection and trend lines. The main use of data mining is that the large data comes into little information. So educational data mining is a design automatically extracts a large repository into the learner's discussion. And why the main use of data mining in education is that to analyze the context of the education to the learner's discussion. And here the data mining is based on these facts. First we analyze, first we collect the data from the students like a survey, and we keep the use the algorithms, the classification algorithms, and mainly this paper uses a multiple classification to verify the results, and the end, the best result we shows the accuracy and precision. And the paper is structured into four sections: related work, data mining, exploration, visualization, insights about the future work and outcome. The main objective is to study to identify the relation between the student's personal and outcomes of the academic based on the previous semesters. It predicts the future semester. And now my friend will continue.
So the author of this paper, like Amjad Rabusa, did this paper according to some other five researchers. And the related work is based on the five researchers. And first is that Bharadwaj and Pal. In this, the Bharadwaj and Pal took research of 50 students based on their previous semester mark, lab work, attendance. According to that, they predicted their upcoming semester using ID3 algorithm. And the next one is like that. So the next is that Abir and Ravi, they are also like two researchers. Here what they have done is they taken the behavior as well as that previous semester mark to predict the upcoming semester mark. And next is Pandey and Pal. In this, what they have done is that using data mining, they have done analyzing, classification and also clustering they have done in this. And they used a classification technique called Rayleigh-based classification to predict their upcoming mark. And the next, the both are Bharadwaj and Pal. In this, they went to a university and then they gave a 150 students questionnaires. And this questionnaires was based on their psychological factors, political factors, social factors and everything. They were having many questions based on that. And according to that, they used that CART algorithm and they predicted that upcoming semester marks. And the next one is Yadav, Bharadwaj and Pal. And they three did many CART algorithm, So these three members used different decision tree algorithm like ID3, CART and chi-square curve, a decision tree algorithm, and they performed and they finalized that CART is that very least one, and also they used Navy-based classification over there. And also these all researchers concluded that not only the marks of the students will affect the upcoming semester, they also their mother's work and their family locality and their parents' qualification, everything will affect the students' mark. And next is the data exploration. And this is data exploration means for understanding the data, we will use graphs and also many other things. And here we are using graphs and also the tables, so that we will be able to understand more easily the data. And the next one is that, so this is the table form of the data which they have collected from that 150 students. And these are the attributes and this is the range. And the first one is the grade and gender, the status, the nationality, and the first language and teaching language. And HSP means high school percentage and sponsorship, and the friends, fee covers and family size. And again the attributes are shown in the next slide, and it is income, parent status and the first qualification, mother's qualification and everything. And this means that all these attributes will affect the students' marks. And this is the graphical form, and this shows the grade points of the students, and which is divided into excellent, very good, good and pass. And this is the transport of the students and B covers of the students, and this is the high school percentage of the students. And the next is that here we are implementing the data mining techniques to this data. So mainly here we are using the decision decision algorithms and classification. And in the decision algorithms, we are using different types of decision algorithm. And in the classification, we are using naming-based classification. And we can also use clustering in this, but presently we are only using classification and decision algorithm. So the next slide will be taken by my friends.
Coming to decision tree algorithm, is a supervised machine learning algorithm. It is based on some condition of the decisions, and the structure is generated, and it includes the tree node and leaf nodes. And the next is, we have four types of decision tree. CART decision tree, that is nothing but classification and regression tree, and one more, chi-square automatic interaction detector, and C4.5 and ID3 decision tree. So here the confusion matrix is also known as the error matrix. So it is based on the performance of the classification model. So in this we have a prediction and actual values. So here we use a CART algorithm based on the prediction and actual. We took here the CART algorithm was available to predict, and here the objects are 270 out of 270 we took 108, and the accuracy value is 40%. And the next is that chi-square decision algorithm. Here the same, but here we took 92 objects out of 270, and the actual accuracy is 34.07. So C4.5 predicts the class. Here we took the 95 objects out of 270, and the accuracy value is 34.95. And ID3 algorithm, and 90 objects. Here we are 33.3. This is the least. Summary. As final analysis, we observe that the CART is a best accuracy of 40%, and the least is ID3, that is 33.33%. And next my friend will continue.
So it is like naming-based classification, and it's a form of classification where we are using Bayes' theorem. And naming-based classification is used because we are thinking all the events are independent, which is not possible. So just we are considering the events are independent and we are finding this. So this is that Bayes' theorem probability equation, where we are thinking that A is given and we are finding the B probability. And based on this, we are finding this naming-based classification. So in the next, it is the graph which is showing the naming-based classification, where we are applying on gender, high school percentage, and also the mother occupation. By this we can conclude many things according to naming-based classification. So in the next, it is the confusion matrix. This is also confusion matrix, in which we are finding that there are only 29 students, excellent students out of 60, and like 27 very good, and 16 good, and 23 pass students. And the accuracy point is 36.40. So, in the conclusion, we can say that first, it is that not only the marks of a student depends upon the students, it's also the other social factors will also depend, such as what I said in the first, like transport and also the mother's occupation and also their languages also depends on this. And here, the main objective was done like that. According to the previous semester mark and other factors, they predicted the upcoming semester mark. So this is what about the conclusion. And after that, the future work is like that. We can here, mainly we have used classification techniques. Here we can also use clustering, which means each data set is divided into small groups in such a way that each object in that group is same other than the other groups. So we can use clustering, and also here we have used the semester marks details. This will be more applicable in also registration forms and also in other forms. So next is the reference. The reference is the same papers what I have said in the before, like Bharadwaj, Pal, and also Ahmed papers, with their order is taken for the control.